You're watching My TV Now, and this is the Sideman Show. In 5 seconds, I will inhale this guitar. All right, let's go to the interview.
We are the Beu Sisters. I'm Christy.
I'm Candace.
And I'm Danielle.
We've been in the business for 16 years. We grew up backstage Broadway. Our parents are both Broadway veterans.
It's our family business, basically.
And we've been singing together since she was 7 years old.
We've done many things over our span of our career. We've been on movie soundtracks you may have heard of, the Lizzie McGuire movie,
Home on the Range,
the opening of How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days,
Ella Enchanted,
and Because of Winn-Dixie. Basically, we've been signed to 3 major record deals in the course of our career, and our dream since we began was to start our own record label, Beach Breaks Records.
Which we have.
And we have written, produced, arranged everything in-house,
family,
in this studio,
on our own time, our own dime, and now we're stuck. We need your help.
The Beautiful Project consists of 16 songs that we just recorded here in our home studio.
Yes, and Danielle actually did the beautiful artwork on the album cover.
Oh, thank you.
And it's been a really beautiful journey, and this album shows so much of our passion for what we do. The lyrics, the harmony, everything is truly our hearts.
I feel like we have something to give the world, a message of love.
Yep.
And we want to make sure our little ones
are okay to sing our lyrics.
And
we want to sing positive lyrics. We want to sing life-affirmative.
We want you to sing positive lyrics.
And basically,
our message in the album being called Beautiful is because every aspect of it has brought out the beauty within
change.
Each of us. And our last name is Beu, and our message is Be You.
Be You.
Do.
Know
Be yourself. The Beautiful Project has many different aspects for the future. But
this
the
is
very first part that we need your help
just
with
the
today.
First part.
21 days to raise $5,000 so that we can make hard copies
hard
of our
copies.
CDs.
Copy
but we need
rights.
To get the rest of the songs mastered and copywritten so we can produce the final CD that you can pre-order and we can send out to you as soon as possible.
Yeah, we have everything else in place. We have a really great team that's working for us, a radio promoter, distribution. We have everything in place, but finances
the finished product.
to finish making our hard copies and get ourselves out there to you.
As a rewards for your donation, we are offering posters, packages full of old and new memorabilia from the Beu Sisters,
original artwork from Danielle, myself, and Christy,
and even personal
greeting
lessons,
cards.
Whether it be surfing or singing.
You can get a personal singing lesson over the
Skype lesson.
Skype performances.
Not a lesson on how to use Skype.
Yeah.
Which I need, probably.
Want to thank you for helping that happen.
Thank you, Kickstarter. Thank you, people who make donations. Thank you, supporters and our fans, friends, and family.
And we hope you like what we're doing here.
We hope you enjoy the
Welcome to the Sideman Show, and today on my show I have a very special guest. Christy Beu is with me. Christy, you there?
I am. Hey, what's up?
Well, we're excited as hell to have you on the show. This is a very, very cool thing for us. They've got a brand new record, her and her sisters, out, and it's called Beautiful. All originals. They wrote, co-produced. Tell us a little bit about this record that you've got, Christy.
Well, it's all in-house between me, my sister Candace, and my sister Danielle. We write, arrange, produce, co-produce with my producer from Miami, who is Andre, with an O.
Cool.
And he's been great. He's kind of helped us revamp our sound and figure out who we want to be as artists now that we're on our own independent record label. And so it's great. It's a beautiful experience.
Now, you guys... you own your own label then? Is that the deal?
That is correct. It is called Beach Breaks Records.
Nice. That's the right way to, you know, I'm so glad to hear it when I have artists come on and they say, yeah, we're not chasing a major label. We have our own deal. Because, man, it makes so much more sense now.
Well, you know, we've already done the major label thing. We were distributed through Virgin and then EMI, and then we were signed to Columbia through Sony. And so we've done that, the big machine. And it's nice to have the freedom to do it our way.
Oh, yeah. Well, it gives you total freedom. Plus, you make more money. In the end, you really do. So what do you think of the current state of the business?
You know, it's ever-changing. And I think as an artist and the creative expression, you got to always be ready for that change and keep, you know, changing with times. But it's hard to read. And so instead of trying to figure out what the machine is doing, we are just trying to make great music that we're proud of.
There you go. You're an artist. You know, that's the cool thing I asked you before we started. You know, is it all originals or any covers? And you said all originals. And I'm a little biased towards people that are all original because I think as an artist, you have to continually be pushing that envelope and recreating yourself. And I'm just really glad to hear you're doing that.
You know, and we love doing covers of people. So, you know, when we do shows, that's, people want to hear stuff like that too, until ours become those songs. I always say, you know, every song was an original at one point.
That's right. Know, absolutely right.
And, you know, then it becomes like this big thing that, you know, people want to hear covers. And, you know, I just love to sing, and that's my job. So if I get to write as part of the expression or perform other people's, I feel really honored to be able to do my job all the time.
Tell me about your process when you're writing. How does a song come to you? Because it's different for everybody.
You know, it's different for us, too, within the group. Our newest song coming up is a song I wrote, 11 years ago probably now. But it was one of those songs that came to me in 10 minutes from top to bottom, bridge, everything, melody, lyrics, all at once. And it just poured out of me. Really something like I don't even feel like I wrote. It was like I was a vessel for a higher power that wrote this beautiful song. And sometimes I'll hear a track and it'll inspire me and I'll get a melody. Some, you know, my sisters are very lyrical driven, so sometimes they'll have like poetry almost in their head already. That, you know, so it's whatever the moment's calling for, I guess.
That's awesome. What song do you want to play for the viewers first?
Which one's you got?
Well, let me see.
You probably have volume one, I would assume.
I think that's correct.
Our first single that we released is called Definition of a Lady. So we can give everybody a little taste of who we are as individuals, as ladies, as artists. And it's a song my sister Candace wrote with our producer Andre. And I hope you guys like it.
And here it is. It's Definition of a Lady by the Beu Sisters.
Hello? Oh, hi, Mark. Hey, ladies, keep an eye on Danielle.
Okay, girls, it's time for the ladybug ball. Danielle, Christy. Hey. Hey! Stop that. Hey, wanna play Danielle? Huh? Come on. Bada da 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 dum. Where'd she go? Where did you put her? Just go. Ba-da-da-da-dum! Let's do it.
Yeah.
And that's the Beu Sisters with Definition of a Lady. And I'm on the phone with Christy. Christy, when you guys are in the studio, what's your process there? Do you guys, do you play your own instruments in the studio? You have session players in? How's that work?
I play keyboard, and most of it's keyboard driven.
Yeah.
We have a really good synth, and we have a couple songs where we have a live cellist that came in, and for one of our songs, Garden of Eden, she's a classical pianist as well, so she's put some amazing piano down. Like, I can't play the way she does, but on the other songs, I do the keyboard, and between me and my producer, that's how we lay down most of it. But my brother Jesse actually plays guitar on our single coming up, and in the studio, we kind of, either he already has a pre-existing track that we really liked, and we kind of start laying our vocals down, but I think the magic really comes together as we start arranging the harmonies and laying.
Well, yeah, come on, you got that sister harmony thing going on.
I feel like that's the story, like a story we tell underneath the lyrics.
Yeah.
Is like kind of what I try to do with the harmonies, so.
Well, so now, how long have you guys been, obviously you grew up together, so you've been singing since you were kids, but what's the story behind how the band came together?
Our parents were Broadway veterans, so we kind of grew up backstage Broadway to begin
cool.
with, and so it's just in our blood. Our parents were both in the original Chorus Line.
Wow.
And my dad was one of the dancers that the show is made up about. He's one in the lineup. So we have a pretty strong history that way. But basically, I always knew I wanted to sing. And so through school, I would do every talent show, every drama competition, anything to be up on stage. And by my senior year, I kind of got tired of doing so many shows by myself, and I knew my sisters could sing. And I'd sang with my older sister in drama things before. But I think actually it was my junior year in high school, and I took my sisters up on stage. And at the time, Danielle was only 7 years old, and my sister Jill was 11. I was 17, and Candace was 19. And the little ones could hold four-part harmony at that age.
Wow.
And I was like, And I didn't even know I could arrange four-part harmony at 17. And I was like, oh, okay, this could be something special. And,
we kept
on doing it.
Well, okay, now let's talk a little bit about, now with your parents' upbringing, I'm sure there was, Christmas had to be special because you guys could all sit around and sing. And was there a lot of music in the house?
Yes. My brother is an amazing self-taught pianist, and so he was always playing on the piano, and we kind of joke around singing around the house. I feel like that's we don't really like just start singing Christmas carols.
Right.
it's more like I don't know, we have fun with it. We have just insane family just from it being so giant. There's 8 kids in my family, so the Christmas tree had presents for 20 feet in front
of it. Oh,
yeah. And it was always a good time.
Well, hey, let's do another song here. I'd like to hear this tune called On My Mind. Tell me what's the story behind that.
On My Mind is just a real kind of flirty song that my sister Danielle, actually our producer Andre, had made this great track. And my sister heard it, and so she wanted to write something to it. She wrote the verses, and they were beautiful and like super kind of fast singing lyrics, and I loved it, but she didn't have a hook, so she came to me.
Yeah.
And we kind of brought the hook together and finished writing the song, and it's one of my favorites, so it's called On My Mind. I hope you guys like it.
Well, here it is. It's On My Mind with the Beu Sisters. Check this out, guys, and we'll be right back after this song.
Do you think of me? Do you? hear your name, from my ears into my brain. I can't stop, filter, refrain. Just wanna explain to everybody that you drive me insane. And I can't lie about the way you make me feel inside. So if you want to caress me, please do. Ooh, I'm so versatile, from my kicks up to my smile. Give you my digits to dial so we can reconcile. Promise I can make it worth your while. Cause I can't hide how you make me feel deep inside. So if you want to caress me, please do.
Do you think of me?
I'm always thinking about you.
Do you dream of me?
Oh, yes, I'm dreaming about you.
Don't you understand?
Oh, no, I can't live without you. Maybe if I can't read the signs, and then you know that you're on my mind. I think you know by now what I want you to do.
Am I coming on too strong? Coming on a little too strong for you?
Are you the kind of man who likes the chase?
Get
too impatient. I wanna make or break it. Do things my own way. Those games I don't play.
We could be creating something so exhilarating.
So stop debating, hesitating. Why would you wanna keep this going?
Do you think of me?
I'm always thinking about you.
Do you dream of me?
Ooh, yes, I'm dreaming about you.
Don't you understand?
Oh no, I can't live without you. Baby, if you can't read the signs, I'm
that's on my mind with the Beu Sisters.
And do you?
Hey, tell me something. When you guys are on tour, do you guys fight like cats and dogs, like every brother and sister does, or is it pretty calm now?
I think we've grown a lot.
Yeah.
I think, you know, of course, all sisters fight. There's going to be bickering because, you know, and it's easiest to kind of do that with the ones you love the most.
Sure.
Because, you know, they're going to love you whether you're being a little B-I-T-C-H or not. And so, you know, when we do fight, it doesn't last long. Like, there's no holding grudges. There's always a quick apology and forgiveness and hugs.
Yeah.
Before we ever leave each other again. So it's not, you know, and it's stupid things like you wore my costume and got a thing on it, you know. So
I've never been in a family band, although my family's huge too. I come from a big family like you do, but I've been on the road long enough, you know, that you know how certain things that are cute, you know, like a day or two suddenly become like you just want to strangle somebody the next time they make that bodily noise or they do that thing.
Well, you know what? I think we're so intertwined because we're
sure.
sisters and
yeah.
we work together. And we practically live together at this point. Our studio house is where we work all the time. My sister Danielle lives here. So when we're gone, this is where she lives. But we're always here working with her. And then, like, when we're on the road, we're together. When we're not working, we're still together at somebody's birthday or somebody's something. You know?
Are you guys touring quite a bit?
Thank God. We love each other, so it works out.
Well, that's cool.
They're my favorite people to be with.
Are you guys touring a lot now, or what do you got going on?
Not right now so much. We're just kind of getting through the early promotional stages
right.
of our new album, and still finishing up some mastering and final mixes on the last song so we can get it, the Volume 2 and Volume 3 out, because actually our album Beautiful is 16 songs, but it's released in three separate EPs, Volume 1, 2, and 3.
Oh, that's cool.
And what we also did, just for the for maybe a listener with different tastes, we took out some of the beats for another version of our album, and they're actually called Inversions, because there's another version within it, and it's more harmony driven.
Yeah.
And it's not quite a cappella, it's not acoustic, but there's just a couple instruments chosen to, and so you can really hear the lyrical and harmony content of each song.
Well, who are your heroes when you were growing up, Christy? Because I mean, you guys have this harmony that's so dense. Who are the people that influenced you growing up?
The Beatles, for sure.
Oh yeah.
I mean, I'm a Jackson 5 fan. Michael Jackson, anything really. I love the Mamas and the Papas. I love the Beach Boys. Our mom was really good at keeping our musical, like being open to all genres and really listening to all kinds of stuff all the time. So one night we'd be listening to big band, you know, Ella Fitzgerald and some, you know, great standards. And then another night we'd be listening to the Shirelles and some 60s, the 50s doo-wop stuff. Then we'd be in the 70s listening to singer-songwriter stuff and then listening to Beatles. But then we also grew up listening to rap and reggae. Sublime is one of my favorite bands. And so I think we have, especially also all three of us have our own specifics that we like more than another genre perhaps, and we bring that into the group. So I think that's reflected in the album.
Wow, you guys really blend well. I mean, of course, you know that family harmony. There's a band called The Standards, who I've known for years. It's five brothers, and it's the same thing. It's just sick how thick it is and good.
Yeah, and you know, and everyone's definitely got their own style, and everybody gets to shine on the album and have their moments. But we're definitely born into the natural placement for the voices. Like my sister Candace is our natural bass. Like she can sing like low like a man and notes that I can't even comprehend, and then my sister Danielle has this super high range like that you can't believe. So it's nice, and then I get to stay right in the middle.
Well, you guys are certainly it's unreal how much talent there is in this country that really needs to be more noticed, is the way I put it. I mean, there's such a level of talent, and then some of the crap that's on the radio that I hear on the radio right now, I just go, how did this happen?
Well, you know what? You can either sit and wonder, you know, and get frustrated and assume that yours is better, but it's not, you know, everyone's got their tastes, and somebody's liking it. Somebody's putting it out there. And so God bless whoever's getting to express their dream. And when it's time for us, it will be. And if it's going to happen the way it's going to happen. And so instead of fighting it anymore these days, I think we've all gotten very zen about the whole idea of what success actually means. I think we're successful because I'm really proud of the album we made. So
there you go. You know what? That's beautiful. That's really beautiful. That's the right attitude. I don't listen to much radio anymore simply because I just...
Nobody does.
You know, I just can't stomach it. I'm glad that it's going back to live performance and bands like yours where true talent, you know, that's what's going to weed everybody out is now, you know, you can't count on auto-tune and all these things. It's got to be talent. You got to actually have the talent to be out there doing it, and that's what's cool. And I love your band. I know.
Well,
tell me about this. Now, you've got a song that's going to be released in a few weeks. Everything will be all right.
Yes, that's the one I was speaking of earlier that I wrote years ago. And it's just a real simple song. And the message is everything will be all right if you don't, you know, sweat it too much. But it was actually, it was written at a time when a really close friend of mine was dying of cancer, and she was living beneath us in the house, like the duplex, and taking care of her and going through that with her. I just wrote the song for the situation, and as I did the first demo, it came out really sad, and it was never meant to be sad. And it was supposed to be uplifting, like everything will be all right, and it was just this depressing, slow song. And I was like, all right, I need to have a beachy, fun, happy field, so it is uplifting. So we revamped it completely and did it the way I originally heard it in my head and wanted it to sound. And so that's the creation we have now. And we just shot a video for it using a bunch of little kids. I teach voice here in town when I'm home. So I a bunch of my students are in the video, and it's very Peter Pan-esque and just a good, happy, feel-good message. And it's called Everything Will Be All Right.
Wow. Is there anything you want? You know, I want to. I'm going to take us out with that song because I love that.
Okay.
What do you want to say to your fans out there?
You know what? I just want to find our fans that maybe don't know that we're back. You know, we had a lot of success with Disney a few years back. You know, we had a song in the Lizzie McGuire movie called You Make Me Feel Like a Star, and the opening song, How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days. And I feel like people have heard our music but don't know us yet. You know, or like, or
they're going
even
to.
The ones that grew up to us, listening to us, that they don't know that we're back and that we have something new and fresh to offer. We've grown up, and I know they have too. And so it's a little bit more mature.
Incredible.
And I think I'd like to reach our fans and just say, hey, come check us out, and we're back, and we're very happy to be back.
Christy, where can they go to see your stuff and buy your music?
They can go to Beusisters.com. www.beusisters.com. You can follow us on Twitter at the Beu Sisters on Twitter, and follow us on Facebook. And we, you know, we'll keep our website updated. And we also have, we'd love to keep connecting with our fans on our YouTube page as well. We keep putting up new videos, and so hopefully people can start connecting with us that way.
Well, they are incredible, and I'm really glad you came on the show. A pleasure to have you, and you're welcome here anytime. Let's take it out today with Everything Will Be All Right. Thanks for watching. There you go. She's going to sing it for you. Here you go. You guys have a great day. Thanks for watching the Sideman Show, and here is the Beu Sisters with Everything Will Be All Right.